Bring back rock.
Hey, this is Dean with Bring Back Rock. Today we're going to talk about a band you should know about if you're a big fan of the 80s hard rock scene. They're part of what's called the new wave of glam metal, the new wave of sleaze metal, the new wave of hair metal, which seems to be the preferred term for this. I'm not a big fan of the term hair metal, but we're going to go with the new wave of hair metal for this video. Those of you who are fans of the genre like myself are probably very familiar with this. Those of you who aren't, let me tell you, there are a bunch of new bands that are influenced by the style and look, sound, and attitude of the 1980s. Some of them sound like they could have been plucked right out of 1988. Some of them kind of take it in a new for the next generation, make their own sound, which is fine. Just got to listen with an open mind. I mean, Rat didn't sound like Dokken. Dokken didn't sound like Motley. Motley didn't sound like Tesla. So it's fine that these bands are kind of finding their own way to interpret their influences. So this band is one of those that sounds like they probably could have come right out of the late 80s. The band is Reckless Love. They've got 4 albums out so far and a 5th one coming. I'm going to tell you a little bit about them, but before I do, I'm going to have to talk a little about another band from that new wave of hair metal called Crash Diet, because their histories are intertwined a little bit. So, tell you a little bit of how Crash Diet leads into Reckless Love, and then I'm going to play a bunch of Reckless Love clips, you know, let you see what they're sounding like, give you an idea of what you're in for, and then we'll see you in just a few minutes. Thanks. So as I said, we need to start Reckless Love's history with Crash Diet. Crash Diet released an album called Rest in Sleaze with singer Dave Lepard, who sadly committed suicide after the first album and tour. The band was going to hang it up, but they were convinced by friends and family to keep going. And that led them to singer Oliver Twisted, also known as Ollie Herman, who was singing as a lead singer of a Guns N' Roses tribute band called Reckless Life. Ollie comes on, does the album Unattractive Revolution. A cool bit of trivia for all you crew heads out there like myself and 80s hard rock fans in general. Motley Crue's Mick Mars co-wrote 2 songs on the Unattractive Revolution album, and he also played guitar on those 2 songs. So, at the end of the tour, Ollie decides that he wants to go back to Reckless Life, which is now morphed into Reckless Love, concentrate on that as his main band. 2010, Reckless Love releases their self-titled debut album. One song on there, I swear, has to be a tribute to Kisses I Was Made for Loving You. Got that dance beat to it, and you really shouldn't like it, but it's super catchy, and you're singing along to it. You know, everybody claims to hate I Was Made for Loving You, but it's been in Kisses' set list forever. So that song I just want to mention. About 6 months later, they released their Reckless Love Cool Edition, the same album, but with bonus tracks. A couple new tracks, a couple remixes, and then some acoustic songs. One of the acoustic songs is a cover of Def Leppard's Hysteria, which is actually a really good cover. I suggest that album. In 2011, Animal Attraction came out. That was their second album and made it to number 10 on their Finnish charts. And that's just a straight-up cool 80s-style hard rock album. Their third album, Spirit, came out. It debuted at number 3 on the Finnish charts. And before the album came out, the single they released was Night Is On Fire. I listened to that a lot before the album came out. Cool video, cool song. Very 80s sounding rock album. Really well produced, and some people thought even too well produced. It had one song on there which people might think is a gimmick track, but it's the only track like that they have. It's called I Love Heavy Metal, and it just name checks all the 80s bands and songs that influenced them. There's a super cool fan-made video of this song. I'm going to try to include it on the description. It will definitely be on my social media. It's called I Love Heavy Metal. In 2016, their 4th album, Invader, came out. Invader's first single was Monster. Really cool video, really cool song. Very Alice Cooper-like, especially the lyrics are really Alice Cooper-like. The rest of the album, however, was a little uneven, as they seemed to let a lot of their pop influences seep into this record. And a lot of people are wondering where Reckless Love is going after that release. Their new album is coming out very soon. It'll be their 5th release. They have 2 singles off of it already. Both of them are more like 80s synth pop instead of 80s hard rock. So we'll just have to see how their new album, what the rest of it looks like. Reckless Love call themselves the Merry Metalers because they are all about the good time, all about the party, good time rock and roll music. If you like 80s hard rock, I think Reckless Love will give you a lot of songs you can really get into. So I'm going to play snippets of a few of those songs, and then I'll see you at the end of the video. I'm gonna give it a shot. Little bit about Reckless Love and a few sound clips to see what you're in for. All their albums are now available for streaming on Spotify. That wasn't always the case, but they are all on there now. So check them out, see what you think, kind of explore that new wave of hair metal that's out there. And if you want to follow me on social media, I'll tell you how in a second. Subscribe if you like it and want to hear more about the greatest decade in hard rock. And thanks for watching.